wonder, how do scientists study birds? Oh, hi, I'm Kaden. Welcome to Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute, where I've been wondering about birds. How do scientists study an animal that can fly around? Let's go explore the zoo and find out. Come on! So what do you think? How do scientists study birds? One way scientists study birds is by going outside and observing birds in their natural habitat. They might grab a pair of binoculars to look around, see what they are doing, what they're eating, where they might be flying to and from, and even listening to their calls. That's a great way we can go out and observe birds as well. But birds, they can fly around and even fly away. So how do scientists study birds once they fly away? Scientists study birds using tracking devices. Some of the tracking devices will even take the location of the bird and send it back to the scientist. These are especially helpful when tracking birds that migrate or travel long distances in their annual cycle. Tracking birds allow scientists to know how birds are using their habitat and their environment. To track birds, scientists will first catch a bird in a net, and they will take quick measurements, seeing how big and healthy the bird is. They will then carefully place a tracking device on the bird and release it back to the wild. That's it. So what do these tracking devices look like? Let's go take a look. Have you ever seen a bird with a bracelet like that? These are bird bands. Bird bands are one way that scientists track birds. They might be color bands that are individualized so that a scientist might see it using their binoculars as the bird is flying around. They can tell which bird it is. Or it might be an aluminum band with a number on it, kind of like a license plate for a car. Seeing birds with the color bands or the aluminum bands allows scientists to determine how long a bird might survive or where they are traveling in the wild. What other ways do you think that scientists track birds? Birds that are banded are wonderful to study, but it does require that you catch or see the same individual bird to study it again. Using radio towers or satellites, scientists are able to use trackers that can send them a location of birds without them seeing it again. The bird is caught and fitted with a transmitter, which will track and then send the info to let the scientists know where the bird is and where it has traveled. The signals may go through radio towers, satellites in space, or both. So what do scientists learn from tracking birds? Tracking birds gives scientists a lot of useful information. It can show where birds fly, the different habitats they visit, and places they stop along the way. Knowing all of this information helps us understand the resources these birds require, like food, water, and shelter, so we can protect the habitats they need to live a long and healthy life. Do you wonder where the birds that you see travel to? Wow, that was a great question to explore and answer together. It's really cool to see some of the ways that scientists are studying birds and hear what they are learning from them. Do you like birds? I know I do. So let's go outside and explore birds. Go outside and observe the birds in their habitats. See what they're doing, listen to their calls, see what they might be eating. Bring a notebook out with you to draw or write down what you're observing, and even some of your questions you want to answer later. While you're out there, help the birds in their habitat by picking up any litter you see and keeping their habitats clean. Once you're done outside, head back inside and do some research. Answer the questions that you've been wondering about birds when you're outside. Then finally, share your knowledge and your love of birds with others. Now, thank you so much for learning, exploring, and wondering with me and helping your neighborhood birds. Stay curious, and I'll see you next time.